Take a look at this. This is the one that went through the lower part of the plastic divider. That's where Matthew Felder was hit in the chest.
Well, they're still partying.
Yeah. Oh, this is going to be an incredible record.
Run to the car, but it was on fire. And I says, are you okay? Are you okay?
I saw them pull the guy out of the car about 12:30 last night.
When he turns around, as he stumbles out the door, amazingly, the suspect having taken around a hollow point bullet.
Well, things not looking too good for the rapper until today. She was facing a felony charge and an arrest warrant for a failure to appear in court last week. Allegedly confessed to authorities. Police tell us that he says that he found God and needed to confess, get it off his chest. This weekend's events all put on by Alonzo Mourning and his wife Tracy, but inspired by the great Magic Johnson.
Yes, I may have started it, but he's the one who's doing the work.
Hanging precariously over that outside retaining wall, as you can see, busted out at this point. Time IBM lab where engineers invented a forerunner of the modern hard drive has been destroyed in a three-alarm blaze. We first told you about it yesterday morning.
Hey, $5.20 a gallon for regular unleaded Gorda.
Yeah, Gorda always has the highest prices. So.
In the nation, apparently. Just
no problem?
No problem.
A Brinks truck guard confirms he's okay after getting held up at gunpoint by two masked men. It happened around 1:15 in front of the community bank on South Dixie Highway in Cutler Ridge when the driver exited the bank with an empty money bag. Unknown where the salmonella originated, but Born to Learn defends its cleanliness and tests of water have turned up negative. $250,000 worth, but they were picky.
But look, he's uncovering the case and he looks at it and he realizes he doesn't like it.
By 6:14 and 30 seconds, they're gone.
White male in his 40s, and there's also a deceased female inside in her 30s.
More questions than answers for investigators as they gather evidence. It's unclear what led to the shooting or who may be responsible. Today, the search looking for the alleged murder victim.
That's when Leo ran in to get a fire extinguisher because he thought the store would blow up.
So I run outside and I started to put the fire out.
All you hear is this real a couple things fell.
Four workers falling one story below where concrete was being poured.
Operated like this would allegedly defraud the airport with time cards, their employee ID cards, and swipe them for each other, whether they were working or not.
We believe it was an apparent strong-arm robbery attempt, and at some time during this robbery, gunshots were exchanged.
Meantime, back on the ground in the parking lot of the Davie Post Office, crime scene investigators place markers where shell casings and other evidence is found. Residents in this area say that this accident overnight now gives them another weapon in their battle to get a traffic light put up at this very dangerous intersection. Yeah, due to all the media coverage, Brian Bethel had really become South Florida's most wanted man.
We see his intentions. He's just a money-grubbing individual who's just looking out for a big payday, but you know, this lottery ticket is going to be null and void.
The store's attorney, unavailable for comment.
Started getting closer. And that's when I started seeing it. It was right here in the front of the house.
James Smith was sitting one house behind where Felder ended up, partially suspended in the air by a shoestring that got snagged on a fence he tried to leap over in his attempted getaway. Marlene Bastien is helping organize demonstrations like the one in front of Border Patrol. She's up in arms over the lack of dissemination of information.
I tried to move them very quickly to some kind of kangaroo courts where their rights are not even respected, where they didn't even know what their rights are. And that's why we want their names. We want the names of these people. If we have their names right now, we can file G28 on their behalf.
Thank you so much for watching. And remember, for news, weather, and sports information 24 hours a day, just log on to NBC6.net. Have a wonderful weekend.